Are you all right? Engine off, engine off.
Tomorrow. You won't be starting at the front of the pack. Are you worried?
It must be crushing when something goes wrong that's entirely out of your control.
Appreciate your time.
It's time again then for Formula One in Shanghai. Northwest of this thriving city of over 24 million people is a circuit that first featured in the championship calendar back in 2004. And of course played host to Formula One's 1,000th World Championship event in 2019. We start a lap here at Shanghai with the long difficult right-handers of turns 1 and 2, the first of 16 corners that make up this 3.3-mile circuit. The incredibly long back straight provides the best passing opportunity of the lap with speeds in excess of 200 miles per hour before the braking zone of turn 14. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position with Charles Leclerc alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Norris, Sainz, Max Verstappen and Ricciardo, Vettel, Russell, Gasly and Lance Stroll, Hamilton, they've taken a grid penalty, Ocon, Antonio Giovinazzi and Matsushita, Latifi, Tsunoda, Robert Schwartzman and Mick Schumacher, Mazepin and more. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
Thank you.
Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
So Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. Let's have a quick look at how the driver standings have changed. That lead at the top of the table has shrunk somewhat today. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from Red Bull this time out, and they improve their position in the championship. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time?
Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend. Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication.